Oh, first trip out to Bourne's. The Kelly Nicholson Report right here on Firebird's Extra Pregame Show. Kelly Nicholson, as always, right here with Kevin Fitzgerald, myself, and Coach. For first time out to Bourne this season. Still early on in the year, but a nice bounce back win yesterday. 4-3 victory over Brewster. How you like the resiliency from this crew to come back down 3-0?
You know, what I liked, Fitzy, was when we got down, there was no panic in the dugout at all. Everybody stayed really calm and went up there and took some good at-bats, and we just chipped away and capitalized on an error, and it was nice to see. And when we can get to the back end of the bullpen, we really like those guys back there, and it was nice to give the ball to Troop in the ninth in the dark. We thought our chances were pretty good at Brewster.
Well, he's gone two straight saves. He's recorded six outs, all six are strikeouts, so that's a pretty solid start to the season for Matt Troop. But that's what I wanted to touch on. You said that there wasn't really any panic at all in the dugout. It's a brand-new group. You know, first couple days into the season, what are you saying to these guys? You're trying to still feel them out. You're trying to learn some of these players. What do you say to a team like that when you're still getting familiar with them in a situation down 3-0 early in a ball game?
Well, we try to stay real positive and just chip away and have quality at-bats and take things pitch by pitch and expect good things to happen. We want to stay positive with these guys all the time. There's not a lot said. These guys know what they need to do. They all come from really, really good programs and great coaches. So we just need to remind them, stay positive. Good at bats, make quality pitches, capitalize when we can, and that's what we did yesterday.
And you mentioned that the back end of the bullpen, the back end of the rotation has looked really solid these first couple days, especially the last two games against Whitey and Brewster. You've been throwing a lot of arms out there. I'm sure you're loving the production from these guys, as you'll have two straight games where your bullpen shut out both Whitey and both Brewster. You're a guy who likes to bring up a lot of starters and recruit a lot of starters onto your roster. Why do you do that year in and year out?
Well, the starters are normally the best guys on the staff. It's when we recruit our position guys or infielders, for example, you'd like to ideally bring up three center fielders. And I think you're going to see two center fielders today. Greg Allen's going to be down. He's a little bit banged up. He could have played if we really, really needed him. But Jeff DeGroat is a center fielder, and obviously Greg Allen is a center fielder, and Luplo could play center field, and I'm sure we could run Fish out to center field. We'd like to have shortstops. You know, Alston Davidson can play short, and obviously AJ's a shortstop, and Vince Conde, who's coming up from Vanderbilt, Vinny should get in here on Thursday. He's going to be our everyday shortstop. So we're excited to see those guys play as well, Fitzy.
How about that aspect of this team? You got a lot of different guys that you mentioned that can play a lot of different positions. Somebody like a Greg Allen can play everywhere out in the outfield. Colin Slaybaugh, he's DH'd, he's caught, he's played out in the outfield. You got a lot of guys you can rotate throughout the lineup. How crucial is that when you look at an early part of the season where you can move guys in and out of your roster and in and out of the lineup every day?
Well, it's really important, I think. It's good to have that flexibility where you can bounce guys around. Slaybaugh's he's a spectacular athlete. You know, how many catchers do you see go play center field and hit second and steal bases when they're not behind the plate? He reminds me, I told Brownie yesterday, and this is a huge, huge comparison. It just reminds me, his athleticism reminds me a little bit of Buster Posey when Buster was up here. Buster played short his first summer with YD, and then they put him behind the plate, and hey, you know, two World Series and MVP, and the rest is history. So it's nice to have that flexibility. We can even bring a pitcher like Colin Wellman, who had 30 at-bats at Loyola Marymount, into pinch hit and not lose anything, to be real honest with you. He's a legitimate two-way guy, so the flexibility is really, really nice. Zach Fish can play first, and Zach Fish can also catch, and Mark Mancini can also run around in the outfield. So it's nice to have that flexibility.
I think yesterday was just a fun day in general. Colin Wellman getting that bat. He'll be heading up to Team USA. You mentioned some of the other names before in that comeback victory. But one name I want to throw out right now is first pitch coming up between the Bourne Braves and the Orleans Firebirds at 6 o'clock. And Coach Kelly Nicholson here joining me. I'm going to steal your word. Who's been Gucci good to start this season? With Jordan Luplo out in left field, you recruit this guy because he's got a great bat out at Fresno State. Did you know he had a laser out there in left field? He's got two outfield assists.
Well, it's really nice to see. I know when I spoke with Mike Bates at Fresno State, he said you're gonna love Jordan Luplo. He's as competitive as they come. He plays with his hair on fire, and you can see that in a little bit in the three games that we've had. He's really, really fun to watch and brings great energy to the ballpark and the ball club every day. So, hey, if there's a guy on second and a base hit to left, you're hoping Luplo's out playing left field because chances are he's going to throw a strike to the plate.
He's got a handful of hits, and he had two straight games where he's gunned down a runner at home plate. Is Kelly Nicholson here joining us on the Firebirds Extra Pregame Show? And, Kel, we'll finish up on this. You got pitcher on the mound today, Corey Miller, who is teammate of Austin Davidson, played at Pepperdine this past year, just got up a handful of days ago. He gets a start today. What do you want to see from him? His really just throughout a first couple days being up here, what do you want to see with him on the mound today?
Right, he threw a bullpen the other day, and Corey was in the rotation at Pepperdine, a really good program on the West Coast, and he was a draft pick. We're lucky to have Corey up here, and a terrific kid, went to a good high school program down at J. Sarah in San Juan Capistrano. And like I said before, I'm looking forward to seeing him pitch. I haven't seen him compete live against the opposition, so it'll be fun. It's always fun to watch these guys compete for the first time.
I'll let you go grab your glasses before they fall off right now. Well, that's not Gucci, but the Firebirds and Bourne Braves coming up at 6 o'clock. We'll call that Gucci, I guess. First pitch coming up in a few minutes. It's the Kelly Nicholson Report. Coach, thanks for stopping by.
You bet. Anytime, 15.